Hello, I'm EnterElysium, and welcome back to Divinity Original Sin 2 Early Access. We need to do some healing.
Oop.
Watery. Right, we need to find an extra person for our group. Probably someone who can be like a tank or something. I'm kind of missing a tank. We've got a rogue and two inquisitors. Bow your heads, please. If we chant Lien's prayer, the divine will rise once more. I will take my leave. And actually, Inquisitor Elysium should be in charge. Also, why are we not healing? There we go. Better. Ooh. Hello, Gorwin. You there. You just arrived, isn't that right? Are you quite alone? Noble is just asshole, so I'm not going to use Noble, actually. Why do you want to know? It's just a proposition. Something very worth knowing, but it's hardly a group affair. I only need one. Go on, I'm here alone. I'm not, but in that case, listen up. You must think me mad to approach a stranger, but this camp is full of cowards and I'm running out of time. Fast. Too fast. Way too fast. What are you planning? I've been here a long time, longer than anyone else. People get taken sometimes. Some folks say they get cured. I don't know if I believe it, but I don't want to wait and find out. I have a way out of here. It won't be easy, and I need a partner. Just one. Are you interested? Oh. It's like a way out, but I can only take myself. I've got companions to think about. Noble, but after the Magus take you, nobility will be in for nothing. Good luck with your friends, though. Enjoy your last days in good company, won't you? I'm sorry, mate, but I don't trust you. Hello, Jeff. A fella can't hear himself think all this racket. Day and night, Shiola's after that child. You hear that, Farah? You gotta cut that out. What's happened to you? If you don't like it, perhaps you should help her. Aye, she needs help, but none that I can give. Mad as a cuckoo, that one, and twice as loud. She seems perfectly sane if distraught. Distraught doesn't even begin to cover it. She's old enough, that child of hers. Killed by a void woken she was. Been dead and buried for a month now. Not even stepped foot on Fort Joy. And there ain't nothing amount of Olorin that'll bring her back. Please, you must help me. No one here will help me. Not one of these bastards. My child is missing. My baby. What can I do to help? Oh, bless you. She's been missing for days now. Not a single soul will help me look for her. Irma's her name. She's as high as your hip. Black of hair, a quiet child, not prone to wandering off. I'm sick with worry, completely sick. And no one else will help in the damn camp. Will lift a finger to help me find her. What do you know about your daughter's disappearance? I just saw her, just near here. 3 days ago, she's playing with a little doll and I was washing her tunic. I turned from her for one moment and she was gone. Left her doll behind too. It's so unlike her. Why would no one else in the camp help? This place turns people cold. Cold and wicked. That fellow Jeff there speaks unutterable evils. I can't move away from him. Why? Okay. But if Irma comes back and I'm not here... Ah, right. Okay, so if Irma comes back and you're not here, you'll... Yeah, okay, yeah. Can I have a look at the doll? Yes, of course. Here, you should take it with you. When you find it, give the doll and tell her Mummy says this is from her little chicken. It's time to come home. That's why I call her my little chicken. She soaks up a steady stream of tears with her shirt sleeves. She ought to come with you then. She ought to follow you back to me. I'll do my best. You're an angel. Truly you are. Right, so I've got to find a missing child and also wherever the supplies are hidden so that I can free the person in the cage. Ooh, lots of people up there that I might be able to go talk to. Leather boots! Ooh, restoration scroll. Simple shirt, mug of wine. Lockpicks. Orange juice. It's not oranges, but it's orange juice, so that'll count, right? Also, I totally want to wear these boots. Rather chunky. At least it's better than having barefoot, though. Let's talk to Majesty Yarrow. You there. I'm looking for an inmate. It was a large bronze ring with a dragon stamped into it. Name of Migo. Have you seen him? No? Useless. It's a very important matter that I locate this Migo. Tell me if you hear mention of him. I'm not sure that I'm predisposed to help you, but whatever. Oh, I just stole a bedroll. I'm sure that'll come really helpful. Brother Buyer. Ooh, a dwarf. Yes, let's get some representation.
Greetings, child. I find myself in your so-called divine lands, yet I feel his absence deep in my heart all the same.
He looks about your age and you thank him not to call you a child. These are no more your lands than his. Yeah, okay.
No disrespect, I. I'm just used to calling it the divine offspring that way. Absent father, maybe.
No disrespect. Oh, okay. Fair enough. Still looking for a new party member. I need a full party.
Looky here, mates. Fresh faces. We love fresh faces, don't we? Oh, yes, we do.
Why don't you join us for a round of cards?
First hands on the house.
Okay.
Chuff to you, Chief. Here are your cards. You're up first.
You glance at your hand. Two purple monarchs. A hard hand to beat. I'll play my hand.
Quite the hand, freshie. Unfortunately, two is less than five, and that's how many purples I got. I reckon it makes me the winner.
I'll be having your fee then. You're clearly cheating.
Blame the bloke you just met for misfortune, are you? Ease off, or I'll go ahead and double what you owe.
Ooh. Mention he's gained more from having you and your connections as allies. Yes, that is true.
Don't think your connections will get here in time to save you if you don't pay up now.
Okay, how tough is he? Level 2. Ooh. I've got nothing of value on me. Go on then, whatever pennies you got in your pockets ain't worth my breath.
Don't you go telling Griff I was soft on you.
Oh, okay, we managed to get away by saying we were poor. That is interesting. I did not expect that to work.
Huh? What are you doing here? Thought Griff had you making the rounds inside.
You've got me confused with someone else.
Oh, wait, you're right. You just look like Christoph, though. But I was reckon got rid of now that I think of it. Sure, time flies.
Bottle top.
What are you after, Pimsqueak?
Beg your pardon.
Well, going around poking Griffguard ain't the way to doing Sack 5, in fact. I'd go ask after him for a spot on your team. Join up's the best way to survive.
Nah, I'm not gonna join Griff. He's kind of a racist asshole. What I need is one more person for my team. Also, my hair's completely disappeared. I like my hair. Okay, apparently death kills your hair. Woman is scrambling at the throat as though she can hardly breathe. As she catches sight of you, recognition flashes in her terrified eyes. She drops her hands from her throat and starts hyperventilating.
Ben Mest? You killed them! You killed them! You killed them all! Murderer!
Laugh at the accusation, clasping shaking hands behind your back.
You can't hide you where you are, killer. Look at him. It's him. It's the lone wolf. Ben Medst.
Okay. Hi, let's talk to you, Mirror. Nope, no talking to you. Okay. Well, that doesn't really help me, does it?
This brow knits together, then apart and back again. He seems to be swimming deep in his thoughts and doesn't look up as you approach.
Seize by the destructive spirit, you stomp on his foot. No. Cough and ask the ground if it really is interesting as all that. Oh! Whoops, I actually clicked stand on his foot. What was that? Did you see someone stand on my foot just now? Perhaps I only imagined it. What have you got in your mind?
My mind? What else, friend? I'm wondering why. All this source, the void of working the divine. Why?
What do you mean? We used source of thousands of years. We use it to heal, to grow. How can it be that suddenly summons these horrors from the void? And where has the divine gone? Okay, what about you?
Say, wait a sec. Let's die. You remember me, right? Laszlo from Whistling Warriors. We opened for your troop in Shoulder. Must have been gods. Around 5 years ago now.
Laugh and clap on the back. You remember him well.
I knew it was you. So they're letting just any old riffraff into this joint now, eh?
Nod and say that he'd better repent right now before the neighborhood's lost for good. Yep.
Ah, can you believe that old crap? Spent for having the sauce inside you. Being like apologizing for the flawless sheen of my beard. So tell ye, lossy girl. Will any of these voices of yours explain why the devil the Order want us to repent now?
Admit the voices have dwindled to just one and it's been quiet on the matter.
Too bad. Always seemed like a fun crowd to have knocking around the old noggin. Even without them, you can let this place get to you, you hear me? The Order might have your freedom for now, but you can't let them take your spirit too.
How about a song for old time's sake?
Now that's the spirit. Say, you know the old dwarven hymn, don't you? Grab a bottle of ale.
Sing back the familiar line.
Fill it up to the brim. Stick your sorrows in there, oh. And drown until they swim. Ah, tell you, when they hear that ditty, I'm right back home with my mates in tavern. Boy, if you're seen like bringing back some of the old times, good old times, take this. Some remember bitter days. Take care of yourself, lossy girl.
Okay, that's lovely, but can I have like someone else to join me? Gorwin refused. Okay. Sam and Baldir.
Please excuse us.
I'm talking to me, not us, Sam. Oh, for the love of Lucy and Baldir, you're acting like a madman. Say it again. What do you say about my wife? Go on.
I'm going to excuse myself. This is escalating.
Well, it's the truth, and you know it. She bet her off. So what if it was messy? I'd rather puke myself to death 1,000 times than let the Reds get to me. If I were my wife, I'd be happy for you.
Flat smile twitches across Baldir's lips.
She never did like you.
Oh, wow. That was rather... The man looks from under the corpse's feet, then turns back towards the nearly finished coffin, bloody hammer in hand.
Is the coffin for the guy you just murdered? Murder's a big word, and no. This is a bed for someone 1,000 times better than that, Snake. Rest her soul.
I saw you murder a guy to death for a few remarks. Murder's the only word for it. Only a coward lets them talk about the soulmate like that. Maybe it's murder. Maybe not all killing as bad as the rest, though. You're starting to sound like a magister. Maybe there aren't something then. Maybe we do belong here. He nods to you and turns back to his handiwork. He lands with another nail and hams it into the panel. Okay. Certainly don't want him on my team. Anyone around here? Fish rack. Giant anchor. Ooh. Tabeel. You spot an elven woman of astonishing beauty. Her entire poise and being conjures into your mind the image of a polished diamond. Radiant, sumptuous, and elegant, but cold too and sharper than a knife. Her eyes are focused on a lizard some distance away, and you get the distinct feeling he's an unfortunate man indeed to be trapped in the gaze of this tigress. Make a quip and ask her why the guy is so enamored, what the guy has to do to earn that stare. No sooner have these words left your mouth than she turns about and grabs you in a stranglehold. You feel the tip of a long needle being pushed a little ways into your neck.
You caught me off guard. No one catches me off guard. Who are you?
Take it easy. Wasn't my intention to startle you.
But you did. Now the tables have turned. You look quite startled to me.
Push a pivot and now you suddenly face her, the needle still all too deeply embedded in the side of your throat. Despite the precariousness of the situation, you notice the one detail on her beauteous features that breaks the spell of perfection, a curiously shaped scar on her soft left cheek.
I don't think I should just go, how did you get the scar? Literally, kind of a bit forwards. Why are you stalking that lizard?
Because it is my desire to kill him, of course. I hate lizards. As for the reason, you're staring at it.
Let me tell you a little story. Once upon a time, a lizard cut this thing, this living scar into my cheek, so that with a melody he could control me like a puppet on a string. A slave was I until I outwitted my master. He's now quite dead, and I am quite free to kill any lizard I like.
I'm not a lizard. She drives the needle in deep and whispers. In truth, it doesn't matter in the least who you really are. You saw me mark him a prey. You could warn him, save him, or kill him before I got my chance. That makes you a liability. That makes you needle feed.
Instead of killing me, you could join me. A bright spark of laughter follows your proposal.
How amusing. Admit, I had not seen that twist coming. It was certainly the pitfall begging was about to begin. Make your case in quickly. Why should I do it?
You're not to survive on your own. Sooner or later, the magisters will come for you. Or, we're planning an escape. You're in need of people with talents like hers. So, one is like, hi, I need you. The other one is like, yeah, you're probably going to die if you stay here alone. I kind of think that she responds better to the second one.
Most probably. And your alternative would be?
Escape.
Escape? Impossible.
It's improbable. Maybe you should just kill me then and see how you fare on your own.
That was not a clever attempt at manipulation, but I take your point. Fine, you're on. I'll sheathe my lust for lizard blood for now, though I can't promise that in the sheath it will stay should we actually manage to escape.
With a casual flick of the wrist, she withdraws the needle from your neck and smiles as if you just decide to sit down for tea. You're not quite certain you'll ever sleep sound with her at any sort of proximity, but at least she's on your side for the moment.
Okay. And you are a ranger by the look of it.
Twig for string. I also probably should give the lockpicks to you. Yeah.
Elegant corpse with arrow cover. Yeah, you're a ranger. Which is kind of frustrating, because now I've got three ranged people. I guess to an extent, like, Inquisitors can be in close range. They do suffer, though. Right, now we've got a lot of people. Let's go have a look at this. Oh, actually, this hatch right here. It was Noosey who was telling me that I should go down the hatch. Yeah, let's try that. Also, I need to do some healing. My hair's come back. Wait, that wasn't me. That's me. My hair's over here. God damn it. Now I need to wait to heal again. My hair's still not back. How long does it take to grow your hair back? Is that like a side effect of regeneration? You go bald. I don't like that side effect of regeneration. There we go. Ooh, what's in the barrel? All right, Noosey, do you know anything about the citrus, by the way? Not scared, are you? Go on, down the hatch. Oh. Well, that didn't really help. I'm completely honest with you. Don't tell anyone what you got this air. Psst, you're a little light in your pack, ain't you? Blame me for the garbage they got for sale around here. Why don't you look at the goodies I've got? I'm looking for Griff's missing supplies. Have you heard anything? Fell in the cage of the thief. Okay, I'll take my leave. Nothing really useful there. Waltz, we'll have a talk to you, see if you know anything, but... Hey, Freshy, what you heard about a crate of stolen supplies? And don't you lie to me now. I'm looking for the crate too. Have you got any leads? If I did, I wouldn't give them up to you. Griff sent me, not you. I'm actually working on Griff's behalf. Look, I'm Griff's right hand, and I'm going to find that crate, and you're going to watch me hand it over to him. Okay. Whatever. Fine. Let's go down the hatch. Let's see what's down the hatch. Apparently not my hair. Do a quick save, just in case. Alpha is alpha and all that. Hello. The thorny one.
You have come to fight. You come to prove yourself. You come to be worthy. There can be only one, and you have but one chance.
What do you mean, prove yourself? She scoffs.
To prove you are the one.
Okay, so basically Neo. The one what?
Never mind. The one does not ask such questions. I'll fight. Good. Who aids you? Choose wisely. Whether you fail or succeed, you do not fight more than once.
My entire party will join. Okay, okay, right. We got a fight on. There's people. There's poison. There's mages and all manner of interesting things going on. I kind of think that we should dive into cover, however. I'm a little bit worried because that's like oil. Ornate chest. Ooh. How do we limit this? Water. Can we electrify the frozen? Oil. What I'm thinking is we split around here, and then when they come for us, if they go past this, we could blow this up with like fire or something. I really want to have a look in this chest though. And there's a chest here as well. So many tasty, tasty chests I want to have a look in. Right. However, we are an assassin, so we're kind of required to, what's the range on this? Not very long. Okay. For now, let's get behind here. And we're using courage. I actually didn't use encourage. I pressed space. I thought that would just cast encourage, but instead it ends turn. Whoops. Oh well. It's not a major loss. That's a lot of burning. However, they are near the fire. Okay. So for one... let's do a heal on you, Sabil, because you look like you're very close to death. Then let's use encourage. And we've got, what, 2 points left? You're too far away. The dog is not. Right, bold inferno. Oh yeah! Burning block by magic armor. God damn it! Oh, they're level 3. Oh god. How are we meant to fight level 3s? Okay, let's use static discharge. I'm pretty tempted to do the dog. There we go. Okay, I'm worried about you. You've got a two-handed sword. Right, let's definitely step out of the way of the fire. Fire arrow. Deals burning. Flesh sacrifice. I lose minus one constitution. I get an AP and 25% damage boost. Ooh. First aid. Cures crippled, poison, burning. Heals target 30%. Yes, we'll use it on ourselves. No more burning. Marksman Fang. Fire arrow that goes straight through enemies. Each enemy that hits. Okay. Ricochet. Well, I'd like to use fire arrow to try and get the burning status on you. Didn't work. No, too far away. Okay, instead we'll move to here. And I managed to walk through fire because I'm clever. Okay, let's walk up here. Whoopsie. I'm special. High ground, plus 20% damage. I like that. Okay, tactical retreat. Sure. Kind of still really annoyed that you're not on fire. Oh, Sabil's down. Warm. You would be.
Right, let's try and freeze. Come on. Yes. Frozen. And let's kill the dog. Sorry, doggy. Had to be done. Right, I'm going to move back. Right, my go. I'm not actually on fire. So I don't really want to move, just in case I do set myself on fire. Could resurrect Sabile. I kind of like the idea of that, actually. Resurrect and then see if I can teleport you up there. You should be able to get some good damage. Just don't die. Right, what do we want? Suck blood? No. Restoration scroll? Yeah, actually, I will use that. And then we can use Mosquito Swarm to absorb health. Right. Pierce enemies' physical armor and deal... Yeah, I need to move down to get there. To stab you. How many turns are you frozen for? One more turn, one more turn. Like, I could get around behind them to start doing stabby stabby. But... The risk is you just die. I'm just going to end your turn. Wait, what? Is she just dead? Yeah, Sabile is just dead. Straight up. That was a water barrel. How did it explode? That's just a crazy powerful damage, I guess. Right, let's... Actually, you don't need to do that. Just hit him with attacks. Razzle Dazzle Grenade. I do not like the idea of that. Blind? Do not like the idea of that. Okay. Right, you got this. Move to here. Then, Sawtooth Knife. Yes! Okay, fully approved. And then loot. What do we get? Terror Grenade. Ooh. Use it. Blocked by magic armor. Terrified. Yes. Sadly, you're still alive. You're the one I'm really worried about. Right. Might as well run to there so we can get a backstab in. Oh, we got knocked down. What is this? Ice. Oh, wow. Whoops. It's the oil or something. It's been turned to ice. Oh, wrong one. I've not got really any abilities. Run forward to here. Target too far. Yeah. I can't really get past the fire. Like, there is a way past the fire, because you managed to go past the fire. Out of sight? Really? Okay. Right, well, let's get some high ground advantage then. Out of sight? Oh, I'm blind. There we go. Ow! Ow! You still blind?
dead, blind, duration, yeah, so blind, like I can't really do anything. I guess I can do stuff at like really close range, but I'm gonna... I guess if I move to there with two action points, I can then... How far can I cast stuff? No, I wouldn't be able to get close enough. I'll move to there at least, so I'm closer to the action. No. End turn. And I am not blind, but I am poisoned. If I can get to the blood, I can absorb the blood. Oh no, I pressed space. God damn it. I keep thinking space is to do actions. Right, let's move up to here. Trigger to get extra action points. And then stab in the back. And again. Right, it's just you left. Luckily, more unfortunately, actually, I can't really get around behind you because fire. Right, let's use encourage. I'm blind. Okay, are you blind still? No. Excellent. No! What? Oh my god, how are you dead? Like, you weren't even in the... The arrow effect actually seems to be bigger than the circle is suggesting. Right, heal. And then... And again. Right, we will use... Bloodsucker. Nom nom nom. And since I'm blind... Can I get close enough? Yes! Yoink! Too far away. And I fell over. Great. Yes! We didn't actually get to look in the chest, though, which is annoying. I didn't need to use any more resurrection scrolls. Excellent! Yay! A fine match, very fine! You may yet be the one. You prove yourself again, and again, and again. What a traveling the path of one should be colored by long common prisoners. I suggest you see the Tinkerer. You're capable of so much more. Awesome. Okay. Hopefully we can get down here to have a look at those chests, because I kind of feel sad. Can we not get down here? No. Oh. Was that my one chance to have a look in those chests? Makes me sad. Oh well, we'll level up though, so that makes me happy. We can get more stuff. But that'll be next episode. So if you enjoyed, like, subscribe, you know the jazz. Until next time though, stay shiny.